Hey everyone, it's Emily. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you for tuning in to another video, and this one is going to be my end of the year empties. It has been a while since I've done one of these videos. Dave had actually threw away most of my empties in one go when I was like just about to film a video, and he threw them away back in, I think it was like October. And so these are just a couple months worth of empties, but next year I do want to just be a little bit more mindful about when I'm doing them. So I'm hoping to do them like once a month, once every other month, so you guys can see what I'm finishing up. I'm hoping with a new project that's happening next year, I will be finishing up more items, and that way you can have better thorough reviews, because I always feel like empty videos are one of the most impactful videos on YouTube when it comes to reviews, because you've used these from start to finish, you know how it performs, you know if you like it from the beginning to the end, you know it's more than just a first impression, because you finish these products and I can tell you whether or not I would repurchase them, and I feel like that speaks volumes when you're thinking about purchasing an item. So I have some things here. It's not the biggest amount of stuff, but there are some makeup-y items, which I've already discussed a couple of them in my recent Project Pan video, so check out that video up in the cards if you missed it, because I'll go into more in-depth reviews on the ones that I did finish for that project. So we are just diving in, and I guess I'll start off with those four pieces that were in that Project Pan video. That way we can just get them out of the way, you know, to go and check out those reviews. But the first thing I have is this lip liner from Wet n Wild. It's in the shade Red the Scene. Love the color, love the texture. It's very gel-like, very creamy, and I loved using this when we used to be able to go to Disney, and I missed it, so I put it in this Project Pan, and it was very successful because I finished it up. The next product I finished was a very big feat. It is a blush from Han. This is in the shade Glory, my favorite blush of like all time. It's a beautiful peachy pink with a little bit of luster to it. Not shimmer, it's never shimmery, but just really gives like a glow to the skin. And I would 100% repurchase. Oh, also I would definitely repurchase that Wet n Wild lip liner too. They're pretty inexpensive. I want to say it's like $2.50 or something, like $2 to $3. So it's not crazy pricey, and I absolutely love it. The next one I finished up was this Lila B priming oil. It's just a small size. I didn't care for it. I went into more in depth on that last video, but I don't think I would recommend it, because I do enjoy my Hourglass one in a similar fashion way more. And then another product I would not repurchase is this Kosas mascara. I had high hopes, it just didn't wow me, and it didn't last very long on the tube before it started getting funky. So wasn't a huge fan, but I was able to use it up. And then other makeup items that I was able to use is this brow product from Benefit. This is the brow microfilling pen. I had the shade in blonde. I really enjoyed the color and I did enjoy the product, but I can't say I could recommend it because two reasons. One, it's a little bit more finicky than the one I love. Now you guys, if you've been on my channel, I love my Urban Decay brow blade. It's been the only brow product I've been loving for like 2 years. One lasts me about 8 to 10 months. Like, it lasts so long, and it's a double-sided thing, so you get lots of product, kind of two products in one. Can't say good enough things about it. This one was going up a really great contender, and I enjoyed it, but it was a little bit more temperamental. You had to put it on clean, dry brows. You couldn't have foundation on your brows, or you couldn't have like moisturizer on your brows, because it just wouldn't stick to your skin. And so it was a little bit more temperamental. If you did have maybe foundation on your brows, it just seemed very smudgy, didn't actually look like brow hairs, and it was a little bit harder to use. But if you used it first, which was, I feel, the best method, if I used it first before everything, I did really like the look. But the biggest downfall for me is it didn't last long. It lasted maybe 6 weeks, where my other one lasts months and months and months. So for the price point, I just can't recommend it, especially since it's a little bit more temperamental than the one that I love. And I don't know, it just wasn't worth it for me. The next one I have is a mascara, which I have fallen in love with and I'm missing so much. This is the Anastasia Lash Brag. I use this way longer than the traditional 3 months. You guys know I'm pretty good about rotating through my mascaras because I have really sensitive eyes. I don't want things to flake in them, but this one is just performing forever. I think I used this mascara for a good solid 6 months before it actually ran out. Like, it didn't dry up, it just ran out because I used it every single day for months and months and months. And I love it. It's a clump-free formula, really great for volume and length. I could add extra layers throughout the day and it wouldn't get clumpy. It would just add more, and I absolutely recommend this one. Would actually repurchase, and that's saying a lot because I get a lot of mascaras from work and I could easily go years without actually buying a mascara, and this one I miss so much that I'm like, Well, maybe. So this one I might actually repurchase eventually if I ever run out of mascara. This is 100% on top of the list. The next product I have is a bronzer, and it's not necessarily finished, but definitely has died. This is this guy here. This is the Tarte Little C bronzer. I forget the name of it, but the packaging is just busted at this point. I have repurchased it already, but in the full size, and the full size packaging is 1,000 times better. This one here is just awful. When I first purchased it, I was like, well, this looks like crap, but the product inside is phenomenal, especially if you have fair skin and you love cream bronzers, you would definitely love this. It's foolproof, it's waterproof, it stays on really well, and it's just so easy to apply. But this is definitely on its last, it doesn't even have a leg anymore, it's just a worm. So the packaging is completely like busted, it fell. This happened quite a while ago. And then also the pan completely falls out now, and then it like fell on the ground, it got fur all in it, and it's just, it's not worth it at this point. But I did repurchase it already, 100% love the product. The mini packaging is awful. The other packaging though is really high quality and sturdy and just has like this different like matte texture. It's beautiful. Anyways, so definitely recommend that because I repurchased. I do have a skincare product. This is one that I also would recommend and have not repurchased, but I did request it for gratis one time. So I do have another one and I'm so excited about it. This is the Cora Organics Turmeric Brightening Exfoliating Mask. This is a 2-in-1 system. So it has a physical exfoliant and a chemical exfoliant. You can do a quick little physical one. Just uses rose hips, so it's not super aggressive. It's not going to like tear at your skin. I have super sensitive skin and this one is beautiful. The turmeric is soothing. Use it as like a 20-minute mask and it'll do a little bit more for you. I really, really do enjoy this. I often used it just as a physical exfoliant in the shower. Sometimes I use it maybe once a month as a chemical exfoliant. It just makes my skin super soft, really even, and I really do enjoy this. This is one of those products, like after a week or two of me not using it, I noticed my skin was just looking dull, and this definitely has helped. So I already have another one and using it, so would recommend this one. You get a lot of products too, and it does last quite a while. We have another skincare product. This is the One Size Go Off Juiciest Makeup Removing Wipes. These are really interesting. I did like them, but I don't usually use them on my face, but they did remove everything. I think I used it for a couple looks that we did at work that was a little bit more aggressive for Halloween, and so I did enjoy them. They're massive. I actually cut them in half to use them more often. I usually use them for swatches, and I will say they are really hydrating. Like the times that I did use it on my face, I really enjoyed the texture of it. They're really soft and pillowy, but they didn't leave your skin really dry or stripped. It really felt nourished afterwards. Like I didn't even need moisturizer. 100% would recommend these, and I may purchase them in the future if I was like going on a trip, or if I knew I was going to do like a crazy week at work where we're doing all these crazy makeup looks. It was just really easy and effective to remove a lot of makeup. And I, again, used them a lot for swatches, and it didn't like dry out my hands or anything. So really did enjoy them way more than I thought I would. So I could see myself repurchasing like the small size. I don't think I would ever need the full size just because I could easily cut them up because I just don't have that crazy of makeup on. The lighting definitely changed right now. I'm moving on to hair care. I have one item here. This is the shampoo I've been using. Already repurchased halfway through that one. So this is the Fable & Main shampoo. I could talk 20 minutes about this shampoo, but all you need to know is that it's hydrating, it's nourishing, does not strip your hair, makes it feel clean. It just has been doing such good things to my hair. I also have the conditioner, but I only use that one maybe once a week. This I use every single time I shower, and I cannot say good enough things. Lasts a really long time. You'd expect the size bottle would only last a couple months. For me, it did last around I bought it back in April when it launched. So this one lasted a good 5 months for me. So I think it was worth it. I hadn't noticed any issues with my scalp. I do get psoriasis with my scalp, and this one definitely helped things stay at bay. So I can't say good enough things. It's also a small company that every product that they sell, they donate a portion of their proceeds to a tiger conservation in India to bring them back into the wild. And I just think that's so great too. So absolutely love this. I love all the products from their line. I've used every single line, and the shampoo for sure is a repurchase. A couple body care things. The first one is a soap. This is the Cuccio Yoga Calm and Clean. It was a body wash and hand soap in one. And this one I had high expectations. It's extremely expensive. I got this in a FabFitFun. They said it retailed for like over $30, which I don't see how. This was like the worst soap I've ever used. On the body, it was very drying, like scaly drying, which I do not like. So we ended up using it as a hand soap, which was fine. It did well, but it again made our hands dry. So I don't understand how this would cost so much. We used it up. I wouldn't repurchase. We have a second one that we need to go through, and I'm kind of just like, I don't know. I'm just not a fan, and I don't understand how it could be so expensive. The next product I have is one of the sponge gels that I got in a FabFitFun. I think this was the pumpkin one. It like came in a set of two. I really enjoy these, but I just don't see myself purchasing them because they only last about 6 weeks, and then you have to like replace it. Even if you got them half off on like a FabFitFun sale or something like that, I just feel like it's kind of pricey for how long you can use it. And I did really enjoy it for the scrubbiness, so I feel like I just need like a loofah with my soap because I have like those little red bumps around my arms, and this really did help. I just don't know if I could justify the cost. The next product I have is this one here from Nanaka. This is the Juice Cleanse, which was in some type of subscription box. I think this ended up being in it was a FabFitFun item as well. This had very little product. It only lasted a couple baths. It smelled okay, but again, way too overpriced for how many uses you got of it. I don't think I would repurchase this one or recommend it because you can get Epsom salts pretty inexpensive. Like I can go to Sprouts and get a giant bag for like $5, and I think this is around like 13, and you don't get a lot of uses, and I feel like it was nothing special. It's just Epsom salt and fragrance, which you could easily DIY, you know? I wasn't a huge fan. The next things I have are just two little minis of fragrance. We have first, they are both from the brand The Seven Virtues. I had gotten their discovery set way back when. I've been trying to go through them. I did go through two of their little minis, and so the first one is an orange blossom. Both of these, I did end up purchasing the rollerball size, or like the small travel size ones. I love both of these for different reasons. The orange blossom one is just a nice, light, fresh, not too citrusy, very just like, I don't know, it's one of those fragrances that no one else can smell, but you can smell it. And so you just feel like fresh and clean and, I don't know, very delicate. And it's just one of those like personal scents. So if you don't want it to be like overpowering, it's just a really nice, lovely, light scent. And then the other one is the Vanilla Woods, which I sell daily at our store because it just is vanilla, but not too sweet. It's like vanilla with, I mean, it's called Vanilla Woods. So it's vanilla, but it has like a woodsy scent to it. So it's sweet, but not too much. It's just like a nice, like spicy, warm scent. And I love it for the winter. And I also have repurchased this one in like a little travel spray. It's just like such a beautiful, it's not quite unisex because I still think it's a little bit too sweet for more of a masculine scent, but it's just a really beautiful one for the fall, winter. So I use my fragrances depending on the season. So orange blossom would definitely be more like a spring, summer, and then vanilla woods I would use in the winter and fall. And then finally we have one candle here, which I would 100% repurchase if it wasn't so expensive. I got this through a Cosbox sale, and this is from the brand Mercy. And it's in the scent Sea Pine. They use coconut wax for their wax, and so it burns like 100 times cleaner than soy, which soy is cleaner than traditional paraffin wax. So this one is a really nice clean burn, even though you wouldn't tell with the blackness around. And that was mostly because when I would blow it out, I would end up putting the coaster that it comes with on top, so that way our smoke detectors didn't go off. Our smoke detectors are stupidly sensitive, so that's why it's a little bit black, I think, more from the smoke than the actual burn, because usually when we burn a candle, it's always up on our mantle and there's like a black sootness going up the wall, and I didn't see that with this. So I really liked it. The scent was so magical. It was in, I don't know if I said it, Sea Pines, but it smells like straight up Christmas trees, and we put it right next to our Christmas tree, and I loved it. Had beautiful throw, clean burn. Couldn't recommend it enough, except for they're $45. So I mean, I have gotten a lot better about not buying like massive amounts of cheaper candles. I'd rather have like one good candle per season. So I could see myself repurchasing it if it was like on sale. Like it had to be like 40% off for me to purchase it. Just because it's so expensive, but it is beautiful and I loved every moment of it, and I was considering repurchasing it, and then I was like, I could spend my money elsewhere, but it was lovely. And if I was like a crazy rich person, I would buy these candles. So maybe I would say yes, I would repurchase it if I had more money in the bank account. Does that make sense? Anyways, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.